how you start an e-commerce business from the ground up with Shopify that completely defied everything you've already known for. I want to make a similar move. It's a good question. My friend Roberto Blake tweeted at me, how did you start an e-commerce business from the ground up with Shopify that completely defied everything you're already known for? I want to make a similar move. So let me explain. You see these masks right here? These right here are Outlaw Masks. Outlaw Masks is a brand that my brother-in-law and I started during the pandemic. To date, we've eclipsed over six figures in sales. We have over 200,000 followers on TikTok, and our masks are worn by players across the NBA and NFL. On this video, I'm gonna share with you how you can also create your own brand and e-commerce store. Let me share a very short story with you. At the beginning of 2020, life was on a very different trajectory than where 2020 ended. I had just moved to Miami from Los Angeles. I was at a different place in my life personally. And professionally, things were on the up and up. So I had a book that had just come out. It was a best-selling book, I might add. I was scheduled to speak all over the world. I had a thriving marketing agency. Life was really, really good. And then right around March 11th, March 12th, right around there, life changed. And it changed very fast. Within a matter of a week, I found myself no longer in Miami. My brother-in-law and I decided to take our families and retreat to Banner Elk, North Carolina, where we got a house and we quarantined from March 15th all the way until the beginning of June. My agency completely fell apart. There was no more agency. Corporate clients had to cancel, pull back on contracts. I had to let people go. Things were bad, like really, really, really bad. But in spite of what was happening around this time, my creativity started to kick into another level. And before I teach you all the fun insights and learnings that there is to know about e-commerce and Shopify, what I really want to share with you is that when you find yourself outside of your natural element, when you're not doing the things that you're used to doing, your creativity really kicks into high gear. I was no longer getting on airplanes every single day. I no longer found myself, you know, eating poorly because I was going to different restaurants. I was no longer doing the things that I was used to doing for a period of years. And again, in spite of the very real scenario that was presented to me, which is a loss of income, my creativity returned to me in a way that I started thinking in a way that I hadn't thought about in years. Notably, how to create a brand, an actual consumer product, not a B2B service, and how could I take that product online, and then how could I use my brand that you've come to know me as to promote that product? Well, everything sounds really good when you're in the planning stages until you actually have to go execute. When faced with an opportunity to pivot in another direction, you must seize that challenge and not run away from it. In my case, and my brother-in-law Reggie's case, we found ourselves at a crossroad where we were no longer working and doing what we used to do. My brother-in-law was previously working in the automotive industry. Prior to that, he was a professional baseball player in the Minnesota Twins system, myself as an author and corporate marketer, et cetera, et cetera. We were no longer doing any of that. But what we did see was the challenge in front of us was to start a product that had a very real purpose in the current times and potentially down the road. And what I mean by that is masks. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. Starting a mask business is really foolish because the pandemic is going to end at some point. And you're right. The pandemic at some point will end, whether it's in 2021 or 2022. But besides the point, semantics aside, in March of 2020, when we're seeing how COVID was unfolding and we're starting to see these trends where masks are being mandated throughout the entire world before they were mandated in the US, we started thinking, well, what if we were to create a fashion forward mask? What if we create a mask that represents who we as entrepreneurs are? My brother-in-law and co-founder is from LA. I'm from South Florida. We like street fashion. We understand hip hop culture. Let's merge all of that into the product that you see here, taking that signature paisley print that you normally see on a bandana, but putting it on a really comfortable elastic mask that goes around the back of your head as opposed to going over your ears. Creating a product like the one that you see here in front of me, Outlaw Masks, is easy. Let me break down for you how easy it is to start a product of your own. You don't need to have a lot of money. What you need to have is an idea. You need to have an idea, and you don't need to think too deep, because what happens with a lot of entrepreneurs, especially if you're at the stage where I was in March of 2020, I had never created a product other than writing a book. I had never had to actually go out and start up an e-commerce store. So I myself, even though I'm a marketer, was kind of intimidated by the process. But going back to the first step, the idea, you need to have an idea, and then you put the idea into motion. So let's say that you want to start a t-shirt business. Great. You got your t-shirts. You had to go procure the product. In our case, we had to find a manufacturer that could make the masks. You have your designs. Great. In our case, we kind of had in our mind what we wanted the design to be. So we worked with our manufacturer to incorporate that design into the product. Creating the product is the first step, which manifests itself from an idea. The second step is you need to find a platform to sell your product. So again, you come up with the idea, t-shirts, coffee, masks, whatever it is, and then you have to go out and find the technology or your storefront to make that product a sellable product. The first thing that you need is a product that people will want to buy. In our case, we created a product that solved a very real need, which is masks. It goes back to supply and demand. If there is a demand for a product, it doesn't matter if there's other products in the market that are like it. Your objective is to create a brand around that product. Take it from me. Do you know how many mask businesses popped up during the pandemic? Everywhere you look on Google and just look up masks, there are fashion masks galore. Creating a mask is not new. In fact, this design, I'm sure you can probably find online if you search hard enough. But what is original is the brand that you create. So the sooner you can get past what the product is gonna be and you can move onto the brand that you're gonna build, the better off you're gonna be. My recommendation is that you take time really studying what are the products that people are buying right now. Five resources that I recommend that you go to research products in high demand are Shopify, Amazon, DHgate, Alibaba, and a good old-fashioned Google search. The next step is going to be your supplier or manufacturer. In Reggie and I's case with Outlaw Masks, we had to find a supplier that was already selling masks, but could customize our mask based on the pattern or the designs that we wanted and also have the different colors. In some cases, you can drop ship products and build your entire business around a drop shipping model. But if you want to go down this route like we did and actually create a product from scratch, that requires a little bit more work and investment. So again, if you don't have a lot of money to invest, look into drop shipping. If you have a little bit of money to invest, look into developing and manufacturing your own product. On a side note, you're probably asking if I purchased a drop shipping course or an e-commerce course, and the easy answer is no. I didn't purchase it. I spent some time researching pros and cons. I was personally hit up by different folks in my own network that asked me if I want to sell PPE and masks. My answer to them was no. As a marketer, this was an opportunity for me to create a product from the ground up. If I failed, I failed. I keep selling books. I keep doing virtual keynotes, and life keeps moving forward. But I'm here to say I didn't fail. And instead, I'm teaching you the ropes so you can succeed and have the knowledge that I didn't have when I got started. Once you move past the actual product that you're going to sell, your next objective becomes what platform are you going to use to sell it on? You can develop your own website. You can use Amazon. Big Cartel is a platform I recently learned about. In our case, we decided to build our own website and host it on the Shopify platform. My recommendation is that if you have zero experience doing e-commerce, that you use Shopify. And the reason for that is Shopify is literally plug and play. You have different templates for e-commerce stores. You have different plugins, everything from email marketing, text message marketing, product reviews. I could go on and on, et cetera, et cetera. Amazon is its own complicated beast, if you will. There's a lot of benefit by having your products on Amazon, notably Amazon being one of the world's most visited websites. But if you know marketing at all, then what you really should be focusing on doing is putting your products on your own .com and drive as much traffic as you can to your .com, which is hosted through the Shopify platform. So once you have your product, your logo, and your website created, now you're ready to sell. This is the fun part, but yet also the scary part. And what I will say is that I've never really dealt with imposter syndrome until May 20th, 2020 rolled around. That's the day that we launched Outlaw Masks. And going back to Roberto's question, yes, imposter syndrome kicked in because nobody in my social network up until this point had ever heard of me speaking about e-commerce or talking about a consumer good product. You know, yes, I'd previously worked for different brands like Winn-Dixie and LinkedIn. Yes, I have a book, but no one really knew me as that guy. So it was very scary for me to kind of step out on that ledge and really take a leap of faith. I'm glad that I took the leap of faith, but it was one that internally I struggled with. In fact, if you look at our content early on TikTok, my brother-in-law was really the face of all of our content. And he really didn't know at that point, but I didn't want to really be featured in Outlaw Mask content because A, I didn't know that the brand was going to work out. B, it was kind of like bashful, if you will. I didn't want people in my own circles to see that I was getting involved in this fashion mask business. You know, it's just one of those things that you kind of deal with. Again, imposter syndrome, you're afraid to fail. You ask yourself, what if this doesn't work? And now people think I'm a failure. A lot of different emotions went through my head. And I think that's okay. What I will say is that once you get your product out into the open, you really depend early on your connections and your friends and followers to buy from you. But that's only going to last so long. Like in our case, I think we probably had like a month of Reggie's connects and my connects that were buying masks. Every time we'd get a cha-ching on our phone, we were calling each other like, hey, do you know this person? Yeah, that's my homie, you know, and vice versa. But once that first month wore off, I think at that point we're really questioning if this was the right business for us. Fortunately, we were able to get through that initial 90-day period, which was a little bumpy. And, you know, again, we're in the midst of a pandemic. We're not really working. We're not really making money. So you start naturally questioning, did we make the right decision by purchasing all this inventory that now we have to sell through? But what I will say is like any other business that you get in, the longer you're in business, the longer that you stay in business, you keep learning. In the last year, I have learned more about marketing, logistics, procurement, leadership. I could go on and on. I've learned more about business in general, how business moves, than probably the last 13 years combined of my entire career, both as an entrepreneur and corporate marketing executive. So you're off to the races and you're marketing your product. Now, how do you go from maybe selling $1,000 worth of product to $100,000? Let me explain. We took a chance, literally a roll of the dice, by sending 300 of our Bar Brawl Black Outlaw masks to the NBA bubble in Orlando back in August. And what happened was players in the NBA started wearing our masks. So now you started seeing Outlaw masks appearing on the faces of notable NBA players. You started seeing Outlaw masks on the social media accounts of NBA teams. And then that content, we started packaging up as posts on TikTok, posts on Instagram, and perception. If you know anything about marketing, you know that perception is everything. When people see that celebrities, and yes, athletes are celebrities, when celebrities are endorsing a product of any kind, that product must be legit. because a celebrity is not going to wear a shirt or a mask or an article of clothing if it's not legit. So in our case, we invested a little bit of money that we weren't making at the time. We sent those products, those masks, to the NBA. And then what I had said to my brother-in-law and co-founder throughout this experience was, the way that we need to look at this investment is no different than a Facebook ad buy. We could spend a couple grand on Facebook and we could just hit people up with ads promoting outlaw masks, or we can spend a couple $1,000s by investing in sending masks to NBA players. And if even one of these players wears our mask and puts it on his Instagram, then we basically spend $2,000 on Instagram ad buy. Case in point, we had a lot more players than one wearing our masks. Our masks appeared in the NBA finals. So all in all, we rolled the dice and it worked. Prior to starting Outlaw Masks, I was one of the biggest critics about TikTok. I was asked throughout my book, then the marketing and subsequent keynotes, what I thought about TikTok. I was not a fan until we started using TikTok to grow a community. To date, we have over 200,000 followers on TikTok. We receive millions of monthly views. And I don't say this to boast or brag, but I say this only because we had discovered that TikTok, as our number one driver of sales and awareness for our brand, has really been a goldmine for organic reach. Now, let me share with you, if you're starting a product from the ground up, like we did in early March of 2020, the way to use TikTok is not even to speak about your product or your service or what you do. You use TikTok to build a community. You use TikTok to drive awareness around your brand. You see, there's a difference between a brand and a product. The brand is what you want to be known for. The product is what people buy from within the brand, if that really makes sense. If not, let me kind of break this down in layman's terms. Nike is a brand. It's a brand that sells sneakers, athletic wear. They endorse celebrities, but Nike has a lot of different products that you can purchase from within Nike. So from the jump, my brother-in-law, Reggie, and I, we decided we are going to build a brand called Outlaw Masks. Initially, we are going to be known for the 8 signature paisley print designs, the Velcro strap around your head mask. 9 months into our business, we have over 44 SKUs for just this style of mask. We're actually getting ready to add another 30 SKUs. We have gaiters, we have cloth masks. We've partnered with an NFL team in the Jacksonville Jaguars to do a collaboration on a mask with a big brand sponsor. So again, this is an example, just one that exists, of how the pandemic actually worked in someone's favor. And it goes back to having an idea. Had the pandemic never happened, I would probably still be somewhere in the world speaking on a stage about marketing. But the pandemic did happen, and it forced me to really just stop in my tracks, stop doing what I was doing, stop doing what came natural to me, and instead use my brain to think about how am I going to get through this while still taking what I know, being social media marketing, and apply that into my business. One, do your research on the top products that people are buying most and build a brand around one of those products. Two, use a platform like Shopify that makes it really easy and simple for you to build a store, and you have built-in plugins, bells and whistles that will help you do everything from email marketing to collect phone numbers to just run an entire end-to-end direct-to-consumer business. Three, use social networks like TikTok in order to build your brand and, more importantly, build a community. Four, you gotta operate fast. What I can tell you to be the gospel about having a direct-to-consumer business in Outlaw Masks is you have to always be moving fast to get product in and keep product moving. You gotta build hype, you gotta create sales. You have to constantly be promoting the product, but not do it in a way that comes off as salesy, but do it in a way that comes off as cool. So for example, we have influencers wearing our product. We wear our products when we make content. Five is don't give up. The first 90 days of anything that you do are always going to be the most difficult. You're not making money. You're fighting imposter syndrome. You're feeling discouraged. People are questioning why you're doing it. There's just so many different emotions that go through your head. So my biggest key of wisdom and advice to anyone that's watching this is you have to stay in the game long enough to reap the benefits and rewards. It's not going to come easy. There's a lot of competition, but if you can hang in there just long enough, you'll live to see a very successful day. As always, you can hit me up at CarlosGill83 on Instagram and Twitter. Also, don't forget to check out Outlaw Masks. You can go to outlawmasks.com. Let's get it.